Are plumbers essential workers? Plumbing is an important job, which has been around for thousands of years. Plumbing goes way back, and at one stage, it stagnated, before we got what is now modern plumbing. The job these unsung heroes do is critical in terms of hygiene and ensuring we have running water in our offices and dwellings. Plumbing is important enough to be an essential service. Because it is on a list, does not automatically make it an essential service, but this video should persuade you that it is. Enjoy. So, are plumbers essential workers? But before we get into the video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel with notifications on so you don't miss any of the new videos we post. The history of plumbing. Plumbing originated during ancient civilizations, as they developed public baths and needed to provide potable water and wastewater removal for large numbers of people. The Mesopotamians introduced the world to clay sewer pipes around 4000 BC, with the earliest examples found in the Temple of Bel at Nippur and at Eshnunna, used to remove wastewater from sites and capture rainwater in wells. The city of Uruk contains the oldest known examples of brick-constructed latrines, constructed atop interconnecting fired clay sewer pipes, circa 3200 BC. Clay pipes were later used in the Hittite city of Hattusa. They had easily detachable and replaceable segments and allowed for cleaning. Standardized earthen plumbing pipes with broad flanges make use of asphalt for preventing leakages appeared in the urban settlement of the Indus Valley Civilization by 2700 BC. The word plumber dates from the Roman Empire. The Latin for lead is plumbum. Roman roofs used lead in conduits and drain pipes, and some were also covered with lead. Lead was also used for piping and for making baths. Plumbing reached its early apex in ancient Rome, which saw the introduction of expansive systems of aqueducts, tile wastewater removal, and widespread use of lead pipes. With the fall of Rome, both water supply and sanitation stagnated, or regressed, for well over 1,000 years. Improvement was slow, with little effective progress made until the growth of modern densely populated cities in the 1800s. During this period, public health authorities began pressing for better waste disposal systems to be installed to prevent or control epidemic of disease. Earlier, the waste disposal system had consisted of collecting waste and dumping it on the ground or into a river. Eventually, the development of separate underground water and sewage systems eliminated open sewage ditches and cesspools. The use of lead for potable water declined sharply after World War II because of increased awareness of the dangers of lead poisoning. At this time, copper piping was introduced as a better and safer alternative to lead pipes. The emergence of the plumbing profession. The plumbing profession is steadily growing. A continuous rise in the living standards requires more sophisticated bathrooms, fixtures, and water systems. People who are studying to be plumbers have great futures, especially in cold areas where the temperature can drop drastically. Small buildings use a simple concept of water inflow and outflow. The plumbing experts design the overall structure of pipe networks, keeping in mind the future needs of a premises. They have to carefully analyze the installation of other systems such as power and gas supply. An experienced plumber should not carry out the installation processes or any other technical activity. A faulty installation of a sewerage system can cause plenty of problems in the long term. On order, to achieve these standards, plumbing has become a profession for which one has to study and be certified. Most plumbers receive their training by doing an apprenticeship, which combines classroom instruction with paid on-the-job training. Most states also require a license to work independently. Apprenticeships are sponsored by trade unions and employers. They last from 4 to 5 years and include 2,000 hours of on-the-job training and classroom instruction. You will need a high school or equivalency diploma and must be at least 18 years old to be accepted into a program. In the classroom, you will learn about local codes and regulations, blueprint reading, and safety. Plumbers are required to have a license to work in most states and municipalities. In the U.S., in addition to needing 2 to 5 years of experience, depending on where the license is issued, you must also pass an exam according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics. Are plumbers essential workers? Plumbers are essential workers. Without plumbing, the world would be a worse place to live in. Plumbers are the only ones ensuring that, with the population of the world expanding, we do not drown in a cesspool. What is an essential worker? The definition of an essential worker is an employee that performs work involving the safety of human life or the protection of property. It comes from the Essential Services Act of 2013. This legislation is designed to help government agencies decide which workers cannot be laid off when reducing their spending. Fast forward to 2020, a global health crisis grips the country and federal and state governments must decide which workers should stay home to contain the spread of the COVID-19 virus. The world depends on plumbing to maintain hygiene standards. It's essential. When there is a problem with the water or sewerage system, system connected to houses or buildings, who fixes it? Typically, plumbers do. When a building's pipes burst, who repairs it? Plumbers usually do. Wherever the water stops flowing, it is usually plumbers who come to the rescue. That's why plumbers made both federal and state governments list of essential workers. Plumbers also support these other essential services: water and sanitation. This category includes all employees needed to manage and maintain drinking water and drainage infrastructure. Not only are plumbers noted as an essential service on federal and state lists like this one, but they also ensure the following essential services can operate effectively. The healthcare industry, both public and private, provides essential services that cannot shut down in any circumstance. These essential employees are too valuable in the case of an emergency. For instance, during the COVID-19 pandemic, healthcare employees perform vital services such as research and testing, patient care, administration of medication to patients, and much more. The healthcare system will not be able to operate without running water with which to clean medical facilities, morgues, and so on. Furthermore, the lack of sewage removal could cause a hygiene crisis, which would place the healthcare system under more strain. First responders, also referred to as emergency management employees, the services they provide are equally as important as healthcare services. During COVID-19, emergency management employees ensure ordinary individuals have access to emergency assistance by law enforcement, the fire department, paramedics, and more. In all U.S. states, first responders are required to work during a state of emergency. They rely on plumbers to keep fire hydrants working and for the basic running of their station and bases. Food and agriculture. During a state of emergency, it's important for individuals, emergency services, and households to have access to food. This means that businesses like grocery stores and restaurants are required to continue operations. Plumbers are needed to build and fix irrigation systems and to ensure the water to these facilities keep running. Transportation and logistics. All employees supporting transportation functions, such as dispatchers and maintenance and repair technicians, are considered as essential. These systems work with vehicles that require water for their cooling systems and for cleaning vehicles to lessen the chance of the spread of COVID-19 or even normal flu bugs. Manufacturing. Manufacturing affects multiple industries and essential categories, including transportation and healthcare. Manufacturing refers to all employees responsible for producing materials and products required for medical supply chains and transportation, such as water and sanitation, energy, communications, food and agriculture, etc. This one is self-explanatory. Without water, most factories would have to close down. Communications and information technology. While many states go on lockdown during the COVID-19 pandemic, it's the communications and information technology industry that is responsible for ensuring the public is kept informed about the latest developments. It may seem like plumbing plays a very small role here, but energy generates heat and systems that heat up are cooled down with water and air. Water in nuclear power plants is critical to prevent overheating and meltdown. Hazardous chemicals and waste systems. Water supply plays a major role in cleaning up any type of waste. These services have to keep running because accidents always happen, no matter if there is a pandemic or not. Water is used to clean nuclear, chemical, and biological contamination. The defense industry. Obviously, the defense industry needs to operate at all times. Our enemies will not stay away because of a superbug, which they may actually create. Soldiers and the equipment they use need water cooling and for drinking, especially in hot conditions. For the water to make it to the forces on the ground, there needs to be a working water infrastructure maintained by plumbers. The finance sector needs to keep running all the time because our world is built on money. Money exists on computers, which is powered by power stations that more often than not use water for cooling systems. Stop the water from flowing and the power stations break down. Construction work cannot continue if there are no plumbers to support the building work. Concrete is an essential part of building, and obviously concrete cannot be mixed without water. Then we should remember that plumbers are also needed to plan and install piping into and out of construction projects. Without plumbers, the building site will not evolve at all and may even be abandoned if plumbing was not planned well. Plumbers are definitely essential workers. It can be argued they are the most essential workers since without them, it would be just as good as living in countries that already have no plumbing. Countries where disease like cholera is rife and where people have to walk miles to collect water in buckets. I am sure none of us want to live in places with sewage running down the streets. What is your take on plumbers being essential workers? Are they essential workers in your mind or not? Feel free to leave a comment. If you're already a plumber, running your own business, or just about to start and grow your own plumbing business, you must learn learn the four critical things plumbing business owners wish they had learned before starting an electrical business so you don't make the same mistakes. Plumbing Accelerator have put together a free training video you can watch for free right now that will show you exactly how to start, grow, and build your plumbing business the right way so you can consistently guarantee profitable work. Free up your time, all whilst reducing stress levels and allowing you to have sustainable and more profitable business that works for you. In this free training video, you will also learn how to generate a steady stream of jobs on demand with predictability month after month in your local area without relying on word of mouth and referrals. How to stop competing on price with your plumbers and escape your competition. How to convert at least 90% of your quotes and estimates into sales. How to command premium prices and attract high quality customers that will be happy to pay more. Click on the link on the description below with the video. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it informative. We would be happy if you would check back for more. Until then, take care.